mama is here to help you out. Okay, I'm never gonna call myself that again. Hey, what's up, you guys? It's Avery from A Very Avid Reader, and welcome back to my channel. For those of you who have never been here, what's up? Nice to meet you. I hope you enjoy this video. I'm going to be talking about how to read more, and I actually have not picked up a book in like a week. I'm kind of hypocritical for this, but I'm like 3 books ahead of my 2021 goal. So how many of you can say that?
Burn!
Maybe a good amount of you. If you are, I'm not sure why you're watching this video. This video is for people who want to read more, but just have trouble with it, because I was like you once, my friends. I really was. I loved to read, but I just didn't do it that much, and I liked the idea of reading a lot, and that was still about all that it was, an idea. And so mama is here to help you out. Okay. I'm never gonna call myself that again. But I'm here to help you through this and give you some of my top tips, because some of these have really helped me read regularly and is why I have gotten through as many books as I have this year. The first tip, and maybe the most controversial tip, is delete TikTok, okay? You have to do it. Now listen, if you're not Gen Z trash and don't have a problem with TikTok, just go ahead and skip past this part of the video, but everyone else, I'm talking to you. For pretty much the entirety of 2020, I was obsessed with TikTok, like everyone. Everyone loves that app. It just sucks you in, okay? But back in February, right at the beginning of February, I decided to make the executive decision to delete it cold turkey off of my phone. And best thing I could have ever done, and I'm pretty sure that's a good reason why I have stayed up with my goal for this year. Now, we could go into the evils of TikTok and why that app is garbage, because I have quite some opinions on it, but that is not the point of this video. The point of this video is finding time to read, and let's be honest with yourselves, people. TikTok is a huge time waster. I know. I used to lay in my bed for hours on the app. It's just so easy to lay there and just scroll forever. And you can scroll forever because there's no end to the For You page. And this does not just apply to TikTok. If you don't have TikTok, but you have a problem with another app that you spend a lot of time on, there was a period in my life where I was obsessed with the Instagram Explore page, and I was constantly scrolling through that, because there's so much funny and good content on the internet, but most of it is dumb. Let's be real, it's dumb and doesn't actually do anything for your brain. Whatever your virtual vice is, cut it out. At least try cutting it out. Try going a week without TikTok and see if you can replace the time that you would spend on said app with reading. So I know for me, I would lay in bed right before I went to sleep on TikTok for a long time, and then I'd finally put it down and go to bed. Okay, so this point kind of goes into my second point, which is make reading a part of your bedtime routine. That is what I do every single day, except for this past week. I've just been on a little break, okay? I wouldn't call it a slump, just a break, a hiatus, if you will. I've been very busy.
We were on a break!
But every night, right before you go to bed, crack open a book for 30 minutes. Just start with 30 minutes. I try to read for an hour before I go to bed every night. But start with 30 minutes, work your way up. It's a great way to end your night. You would just be spending that time doing something else. You'd be on social media, you would be watching Netflix, watching YouTube. Just replace it with reading. And if you don't want to quit cold turkey, start by doing 30 minutes of, you know, technology time, and then 30 minutes of reading. Baby steps, baby. Not to mention, there are tons of studies about how staring at a screen right before you go to bed is not good for you. It makes it harder to fall asleep, and it just makes you have a like restless sleep. So if you've been on your phone or on your computer for a long time, then go ahead and log off and open up a book, you know, good old paper and ink, and let that be the last thing that you are looking at. And that will just do good things for your mind, for your sleeping habits. I go to the extreme and I set all my alarms for the next morning, and I listen to white noise when I sleep. I put my white noise on so that when I'm done reading, I can literally close my book, turn off my light, and go straight to bed without picking up my phone. I know every single one of you lays in bed on your phone until the moment you go to sleep. Okay? Am I wrong? If I'm wrong, let me know. I don't think I'm wrong. You just have to have the willpower to replace it with something else. If you want to read more, replace being on your phone right before you go to bed with reading. I don't know about you, but I'm busy during the day. I've got stuff going on. I have a job. I have classes I'm taking. So I don't have time to like crack open a book at noon. So it's not really feasible for most people to just read in the middle of the day unless it's a weekend. So that will just definitely make it easier to read is if you set time to do it at the end of the day instead of, you know, trying to fit it into your hectic schedule. My next tip, which might sound just obvious, but it is read something that you're interested in. This is going to be really important if you're trying to read more. You need to throw out all of the societal expectations of what you should be reading. Don't crack open. How many times have I said crack open in this video? I never say that. Don't just start reading Brave New World because it's a classic and it's like smart people have read that book. That book is boring. Okay? I don't like that book. If that is not something you're interested in reading, don't try to read it. Read something that, you know, is gonna keep your attention, even if it's just some beach read book or something trashy. Read Twilight if you want to read Twilight. Do you know what I mean? Don't let, you know, the idea of what you should be reading stop you from reading what you want to read, because that is a surefire way to stop reading, is if you're reading something boring because you just feel like you should be reading it. You want to read something that's going to capture your interest. The next tip is if you know that you're kind of a goal-oriented person, to make a goal for how many books you want to read in a set period of time. So the way most people do this is through the app Goodreads. So Goodreads has a reading challenge every single year where at the beginning of the year, you input how many books you want to read in that year and you mark off every time you've read a book through Goodreads, and there's a little progress bar that shows you how far you are throughout the year. Let's just say that progress bar is muy satisfying, okay? I love it. If you're one of those people who doesn't need to see that they're accomplishing something, then, you know, maybe this isn't the tip for you, but I love it. I love looking at my progress bar and being like, dang girl, look at you, just rising and grinding. And even if you don't have Goodreads, you don't have the app, we're only halfway through the year, so all you need to do is download it and just set your goal for how many books you want to read by the end of the year, and you can still use the progress bar and everything. You'll just kind of start now. My next tip is utilize the community we love here called BookTube. There are like a million BookTubers, and every single one of us all has slightly different tastes. There are some BookTubers I'm subscribed to who have pretty much the same exact taste as I do. There are some that I'm subscribed to that just focus on romance books. There are some that I'm subscribed to that just focus on fantasy books. And even though I don't read those two, you know, exclusively, I enjoy their content and I enjoy getting recommendations from, you know, channels that are different than mine. If you kind of explore BookTube, you're gonna find a YouTuber who really speaks to you, who you have the same taste as. You know, it might be one of the amazing BookTubers that has like thousands and thousands of subscribers, or it might be someone who only has, you know, almost 500. What? Who said that? Anyway, I know that I have found so many interesting books just by watching people's BookTube videos, books that I would have never heard about, and my TBR has grown like a mile long after joining BookTube. You know, so sometimes I like joke about how my TBR is so long it's impossible, but it's also really encouraging because I just have a list of books that all sound amazing that I just, you know, constantly want to jump to the next one. So definitely, you know, search around the tube and see what you can find. My last suggestion is to use audiobooks. This video is sponsored by Audible. Just kidding. If you really struggle to find time to read, then audiobooks are probably for you. I personally don't love audiobooks because I find that when I'm not staring at the page, my mind will definitely wander. Audiobooks are still great. That kind of sounded like an anti-audiobook thing. But this is for if you don't have time. So my mom is one of those people who is always just out and about, always around town doing stuff, and she loves audiobooks. And I honestly get kind of mad because she gets through books so much quicker than I do, because I sit and I read, and she is out driving around for hours and she's listening to her books, or she's working in the yard or working in the house for hours on end, and she just constantly has her audiobook going. And so she's gotten through a lot of books this year just by listening to audiobooks. So if that sounds like you, if you're one of those people who is constantly driving for work, or if you're constantly doing stuff that you're busy with your hands but you can let your mind listen to something else, then definitely try audiobooks. Okay, so that is it for this video. I hope that you enjoyed. I hope that I gave you some good tips. If I didn't, then sorry. If you have any really good tips that have helped you read a lot, then go ahead and leave a comment in the description, because I'm sure everyone can benefit from it. I know I could probably benefit from it as well. If you can see, I have a suitcase right here, and it is because I'm about to embark on a fun trip. And while I'm on this trip, I have quite a few video ideas that I want to make, and it's going to be really exciting, in my opinion. I will leave it as a surprise as where I'm going and what I'm going to be doing, but I have some fun video ideas, so stay tuned for those. Anyway, thank you again for watching. If you enjoyed, make sure to give it a like and subscribe if you want to see more videos from me. Thank you so much for watching. I will see you in my next video.